Okay, children, in our last class, that is, I believe on Thursday, we completed the exercise 13.1. Okay, now we will go further. Exercise 13.1 was all about the direct proportion. Okay. Direct proportion means when the value of one increases, the other value with respect to it also increases. Yes? So if there are two values of x and y, let's take cost of one book, rupees 2, cost of two books, rupees 4, like this. So if one value increases, the other value also used to increase. Yes, and we used to find the unknown value by cross multiplying. That is, they were in direct proportion, we used to just find out by cross multiplying, getting the value of the unknown thing. Okay, got it? Now, when one increase, the other also increases, then the values are said to be, or the situations are said to be, directly proportional. In such case, we write like this. X is directly proportional to Y. Okay. What if, we took the example also. Cost of one book, cost of two book, cost of 10 book, cost of 20 books. Okay. What if the value of 1 increases, but with respect to it, the other value decreases? How is that possible? Let's take an example. Suppose, a vehicle is running at a speed, of 20 kilometers per hour. Let's take a train. A train is going at a speed of 20 kilometers per hour. Okay. So, it is completing the destination. It is completing the destination in 5 hours. Okay. Now, if you increase the speed, of the train, instead of 20 kilometers per hour, if it goes 40 kilometers per hour. See, value of x is increasing. Value of y should also increase. That means the time should be taken more by the train. But is that so? No. Instead, the time taken by the train will be just half of 5 hours, or maybe you can say 2.5 hours. Okay. So here, when the value of x is increasing, the value of y is decreasing. So in such case, is it direct proportion? Is it direct proportion? No. In this case, the situation is in inverse proportion. And how do we show it? We show like this. X is, or y is inversely proportional to x, or x is inversely proportional to y, and the situation is known as inverse proportion. Okay, and how do we find the unknown value? Here we do this. Yes, in direct proportion we directly do the cross multiplication. In inverse proportion we do not multiply directly, but instead we do x1, y1, multiplication of x1, y1, that is first value and first value, and multiplication of second value and second value. That is, if this is x1, this is x2, this is x3, then this is y1, this is y2, and this is y3. So, x1, y1 should be equal to x2, y2, that is, these two should be equal to these three, x3, y3, that is, the product of the values of x and y should be equal. In which proportion? In inverse proportion. And in direct proportion, this product is equal. That is, x1 y2 into x2 y1. Clear, children? So this is all about your direct proportion and inverse proportion. Okay, this may be asked. Okay, this I can ask you in the exam also. So remember that. That is very very important. Now, depending upon the inverse proportion, there is a trivees given on page 211. Trivees is given on page 211. We are going to do it now. We have to find out, observe the following tables and find which pair of variables, here x and y, are in inverse proportion. So let's make the table. This is x, this is y. So let's check. What did I say? In inverse proportion, this product of these two values, that is, this is x1, this is y1, x1, y1. Should be equal to x2, y2. So let's check. What is x1, y1? 50 into 5. 5, 5 is 25. This is 250. And this is 4, 6 are 24. And 0, 240. Are they equal? No. Right? So here, when we check the first value only, they are not equal. So, is this first one is inversely proportional? No. So directly we can write, no. They are not inversely proportional because x1, y1 is not equal to x2, y2. Okay? Then we go to the second one. Let's do the second one. Let me change the pen. Again, 60 and 2 more zeros. So, 6000. Here the products are same. That is, x1, x2 is equal to x1, y1 is equal to x2, y2 is equal to x3, y3 is equal to x4, y4. So, yes, the data is inversely proportional. That is, the given value is in inverse proportion. Okay. Then we start with the third one, children. Let's see the value of x and y once again. Let's check whether the values are equal or not. Which values? x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, x4, y4, x5, y5, x6, y6 product. Okay. So, your 90 into 10? 900. 6, 5 is 30. 900. 245 is 90. 0, 900. This is 750. See here. These were equal. But here, the value became unequal. Here also if you do, this is 600. Here also some value will come. So, all are unequal. From here, from the last three values are unequal. Okay, so answer is what? Answer is no. They are not in inverse proportion. Okay, now children, we are going to start the exercise, that is exercise 13.2, which is on page 213. Let's start. Ouch. Question number one, we can do in the book itself. Because we have to just put a tick. Which of the following are in inverse proportion? So, which of the following are in inverse proportion? The number of workers on a job and the time to complete the job. The number of workers and time. If two workers are there, then 2 days. If four workers are there, then also 2 days. No, less days. No, maybe only 1 day. Right? So here, the variation is, means the values, if one is increasing, the other is decreasing. So here the variation is inverse, that is, we'll say it is inversely proportional. So first one is, in inverse proportion. Time taken for a journey at the distance traveled with a uniform speed. Uniform speed means speed remains the same. So the time taken for the journey and the distance traveled. The more is the distance, the more will be the time taken. Okay, if the speed remains the same. Okay, so is it inverse? No, it is direct. How much? If the distance increases, time also increases. Area of cultivated land and crop harvested. Now, area of cultivated land, if this much is the area, so this much are the crops. Okay, if more is the area, more are the crops. So one is increasing, the other is also increasing. Hence, this is also in direct proportion. Time taken for a fixed journey and the speed of the vehicle. So, time taken for the fixed journey. Journey is fixed. Like for example, if you have to travel only and only 5 kilometers, then how much time is taken with respect to speed? So, more speed increases if the speed is 10 kilometers. Maybe time taken is 1 hour. If the speed is 20 kilometers, time will become less. Right? So, if one is increasing, the other is decreasing. So, this is inverse proportion. The population of a country and the area of a land per person. So more is the population of the country, then area of land for one every person will decrease. No? Why? Because more people will live in that area. Okay. More the population is, so area will keep on decreasing. Why? Because more people will take the place. They will come and live in a particular place. So, the proportion is not in between the population and person. Okay. More is the population, more is the number, less will becomes the area for each person. Okay. Like for example, if there are only 60 children in the class, nicely all will sit in the given area. Okay. Now, if I bring one more section, if I say 10 more children will sit today. So, what will happen? You will have to sit congestedly, right? So, what will happen now? The area for one particular child will decrease. Okay, so this is what? This is also inverse for proportion. Why? Because population is increasing. So, the area is decreasing. Okay, children? So, this completes your question number one. Then we go to question number two. Question number two also you can do in the book itself. Why? Because it's just a blank. We have to fill up the blank. In a television game show, the prize money is of rupees 1 lakh and it has to be divided equally among the winners. Complete the table and find whether the prize money given to an individual winner is directly or inversely. That means if the number of people are increasing, is the prize money also increasing? If the prize money is increasing, that means it is directly proportional. But if the prize money is decreasing, then it is inversely proportional. Okay? So, let's start. This is the winners. And this is the money. The prize money. So, for one winner,
1 lakh. Two winners, 50,000. Four winners, we don't know. Five winners, then 8 is there, then 10 is there, and then 20 is there. So children, the first thing you notice something. Notice this. When the person is 1, he or she is taking 1 lakh rupees. When the people are 2, persons are 2, then they are taking half. Okay? So when the number of persons, the winners is increasing, the prize money is decreasing. So this is in which proportion? This is in inverse proportion. So the second part of the question, which proportion it is? It is in inverse proportion. Okay, now we have to find the value of this. So we take this as x. So x1, y1, x2, y2. So 1 into 1 lakh is equal to 4 into x. So 4 shifts this side to get the value of x. So 25,000. Similarly, if we divide 1 lakh to 5, it becomes 20,000. If we divide 1 lakh to 8 ones are 8, 2s are 16. So this is 12,500. Then this becomes 10,000. And 20. Becomes 5,000. Okay. So this is how we will complete the question number 2. Now we go to the next question. Question number 3. Okay. This is also a table. But there are certain questions also to solve. So children, either you do it in book or in copy. No problem. As you wish. Rehman is making a wheel using spokes. He wants to fix equal spokes in such a way that angles between any pair of consecutive spokes are equal. Help him completing the following table. So children, we all know what are the spokes. We have seen the bicycle. It has a wheel and this is the spokes, these lengths. Okay, now he wants to fix equal spokes in such a way that the angle between the pair of consecutive spokes are equal. That means this angle formed should be equal. In such a way, he wants to fix the spokes. Okay, so for that we have to complete this table. Okay, now we all know this is what? 90 degree, this is what? 180 degree, this is also 180 degree. So this is a complete angle, 180 plus 180, 360. So we know the complete angle, yes? So we divide the number of spokes and we will come to know the angles, okay, between two consecutive spokes. And that's how we are going to complete this table. So let's start.
So this is number of spokes and this is the angle. 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12. So as you see, first thing you see this. You make this table in your copy. Now you see, when there are 4 spokes, angle is 90 degrees. 6 spokes, angle has become less. That means your x is increasing but y is decreasing. That means this is which the values are in which proportion. Every time I am saying variation, variation. In which proportion? They are in inverse proportion. Okay. The condition is in inverse proportion. So when it is inverse proportion, what do? We multiply x1, y1 and x2, y2. Okay. So this becomes x1, this becomes y1. X2, Y2, X3, Y3, Y4 and Y. So we have to find out these 3 values. Okay. So X1, Y1 is equal to X2, Y2. That is, no, X3, Y3. We'll write X3, Y3. X3, Y3. What is X1? 4 into 90 is equal to 8 into Y3. We'll shift 8 here. So 4 into 90 by 8 is equal to Y3. So 4 ones are, 4 twos are, 2 ones are, 2 45s are. So the answer is here what? 45 degrees. So 45 degrees is Y3. Okay. This is the first one. Then we have to start the second one. So again. X1, Y1 is equal to X4, Y4. Okay, or you can take this also, X3, Y3 is equal to, and that's how you can get the value. So, X1, that is 4 into 90 is equal to 10 into Y4. 10 transposes here, so 4 into 10 by 4 into 90 by 10 is equal to Y4. 0, 0 got cancelled, 4 nines are 36 degrees is Y4. So the value of Y4 is 36 degrees. Okay. Again, X1, Y1 is equal to X5, Y5. That is 4 into 90 is equal to 12 into Y5. 12 transpose this side by 12 is equal to Y5. 4 ones are 4. 3's are 12, 3 ones are 3, 30's are. So 30 degrees is Y5. So 30 degrees is Y5. Okay, this completes. Then we go to the first part. There is first part of the question also. Okay, we were doing the zero part. Okay, now we are starting the first part. Are the number of spokes and the angles formed between the pairs of consecutive spokes are in inverse proportion? Is it inverse? Yes. Why? As the value of x is increasing, the value of y is decreasing. So the first one is, the first answer is yes. Okay, now we move to the second part. And the angles formed, second part is calculate proportion.
proportional divider is. Proportion.
Calculate the angle between a pair of consecutive spokes on a wheel with 15 spokes.
So when 4 spokes, it was 90 degree. Now when 15 spokes, then we don't know. So angle should be x degrees. Okay, we take it as y, y degrees. So this is the table. Okay. Now, the situation is in which proportion, inverse proportion. Na? So, since the condition is in inverse proportion, hence
that is 4 into 90 is equal to 15 into y. Now 15 shifts this side. 4 by 90. 3 5s are 3 30s are. 5 1s are. 5 6s are. 4 6s are 24 degrees. So the answer is 24 degrees. What will be the angle? If 15 spokes are there, then the angle between two consecutive spokes will be 24 degrees. Then the third part, how many spokes would be needed? If the angle is given 40 degrees. So when 4 spokes are there, 90 degree, when 40 degree, then how many spokes? So let the spokes be x. Okay, so let the number of spokes needed be x. Since the condition is inverse, then 4 into 90 is x into 40. 40 shifts this side. 4 into 90 by 40 is equal to x. 0, 0 got cancelled. 4, 4 got cancelled. What is left, children? 9. So, answer is how many spokes? 9 spokes. Okay? And this completes question number 3.